la 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 la.
While limiting ourselves to the confinement of the miracles of the first verse of the first chapter of the Holy Quran, that's the Basmala. The Basmala is the reflection of Muhammad, and Muhammad is the reflection of La ilaha illallah, meaning there is only one God, Allah. That's the Tahleel. Now, therefore, you can put down the Tahleel has La ilaha illallah has four ways, right? Four and 12 letters and write 12 behind 4. We have 412. Then Muhammad has 4 letters with a sum of 92. So write 4 after 4, write 92. It gives you 492. Then the word Allah has 4 letters. And if you sum up the word Allah, you get 66. And the 4 letters added to 66 will give you 70. So write 4. After 4, you write 70. Then you get 470. And the figures that you are going to have now is 412,492,470. This number is divisible by 19 without a remainder. When you divide it by 19, it gives you 21,710,130. And if you sum up the total or the result of the division to a single digit, you get 6. This is very, very miraculous. This all is coming from the Basmala. This figure you get is when Muhammad reflects, then it is Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. When La ilaha illallah reflects, then it is Muhammad. So the Basmala is a reflection of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad is a reflection of the Tahleel, the Kalimat al-Tawheed, that is La ilaha illallah.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulullah. The number 19, as we have already demonstrated, and I would like to bring you up to speed for you to understand the number 19.
The fact is, the Holy Quran is the greatest and most miraculous book in existence. That is to say, the least about the Quran. And uttering a similar book is beyond the capability of both mankind and extraterrestrial entities, or jinn kind. Reference Quran chapter 17 verse 88. I have repeatedly indicated that each letter in the Holy Quran has its own vibrational sequence, its own frequency resonance, its own law of attraction, and its own electromagnetic force. This also applies to all the words, all the verses, and all the chapters in the Holy Quran.
The number 19 is a number that the Almighty Allah has chosen to preface all the 114 chapters in the Holy Quran. It is only chapter 9, that Surah Tawbah, that the Basmala is not prefaced. And as I already indicated, in chapter 27, you have 2 Basmalas. One extra Basmala has been catered for to replace the Basmala that was missing on Surah Tawbah. Now we have 114 Basmalas, 114 chapters. So 114 is divisible by 19. Now all letters and all words and all verses and all chapters should be divisible by 19. If it's not, then you should know that there's a problem there. Either the problem is from you or the problem is from some of the scholars, the custodians of Islam. Now, the number 19 is a very important number, as we have already indicated in chapter 74, verse 31, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alayha tis'atu ashara, upon it is the number 19. And he referred to the number 19 as the guards of hell. One of the scholars in Islam, Tabari, he was first to indicate, even though there were numerous referrals to the number 19 representing Zabaniya, that is the names of the guards of hell. He, Tabari, said that if you recite Bismillah Rahman Rahim, the Basmala, the letters in Bismillah Rahman Rahim are 19, and each letter in that is the first verse of the first chapter of the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is protecting you against the punishment of all the 19 Zabaniyas in hell. So the number 19 is very, very important. All right. So let us come now to the number 19. Now that we are all familiar with the number 19, to you as doctors here studying medicine, the number 19 is not a number that you are not aware of. You are completely aware of the number 19 and you know it. But there are some specifics that will bring you up to speed on. And there are some dynamics. I want you to understand the number 19. Now, we have two numbers there. That is two digits, 1 and 9. The meaning of one actually means that the Almighty Allah. And it's not only one, because if you say one, you go to two. And Allah is far from getting a second or to being two. So if you go to one, you can go to two. If you go to first, you can go to second. But one there is one and only. If they say one and only, the one and only God, Allah, that's the essence of La ilaha illallah. So you can get to second. You can go to two. Let alone go to three. It's one and only. One and only Allah. So if the one represents Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And 19 means Allah and his creation of 9 things that he has created in the universe. Now, and who did he use to bring into existence creation? He is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Now, I think you are also familiar with the book I have written about the Muhammadan light.
As I also indicated earlier, that the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was created special and specially designed with the most powerful transceivers, that is BTS, in order to absorb the shocks from the divine level and cool it down to the level of humanity, so that humanity will be in the position to recite it and understand it when it was transmitted to him. Interestingly, the perception of the Holy Quran about the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, can be read from Quran chapter 5 verse 15, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares, "O people of the book, indeed our messenger has come to you to make clear to you lots of what you concealed in the scriptures, and to ignore more. Allah has sent to you a light. The light is electromagnetic force, frequency, resonance, vibrational sequence, and the law of attraction representing the 4 letters in Muhammad, and with a book that makes things clear." The light here refers to the 4 letters in the word Muhammad: the electromagnetic force, the frequency, resonance, vibrational sequence, and the law of attraction representing the 4 letters in Muhammad. So computing the word Muhammad, you have a sum of 92, and 9 plus 2 you get 11, and 1 plus 1 you get 2. Likewise, this particular chapter, the number and the verse, which are chapter 5 verse 15. So 5 plus 1 plus 5 you get 11, and 1 plus 1 you get 2, and that's is obviously the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. One of the renowned contemporary Islamic scholars from Egypt, Sheikh Shahrawi, declared in his tafsir, volume 5, page 3026, that the light in this verse, that is chapter 5, verse 15, is referring to the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, by quoting the famous hadith of Jabir bin Abdullah. Jabir narrated that he asked the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, of the first thing Allah created before anything else. The Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, answered him thus, the light of your prophethood, Jabir.
So the figure 9 is 3 and 6. Now, what is 6? 6 is the period in which the Almighty Allah has used to create the whole of mankind and the universe. 6. So it means that Allah has created, used 6 to create space. In the first place, if you are on earth, you are in space. If you are on the moon, you are in space. If you are even on any planet, be it our solar system or what we call galaxies, you are still in space. He created all that in 6 days. إِنَّ رَبَكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ. He created the heavens inclusively, including the earth and what it contains in 6 days. Now, the 6 days is creation in general, consisting of space. All the planets, the galaxies are swimming in space, and they are swimming with vibrational sequence, as well as frequency resonance and electromagnetism. And the fourth is the law of attraction. Then the remaining 3 that is left over, the 3 is what? You already know it, you are familiar with that. The 3 is what?
Time.
And time consists of past, present, and future. The 3 things. So the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to create these 9 things. Now you see that everywhere in the Holy Quran, Allah refers to time as ajalin musamman, appointed time. So after creating all these things that we see, we call them as stars or galaxies or whatever, he trimmed the time. Like you people didn't see. In the olden days, our watches were being what? Being trimmed. You have to wind your time. And then as the time goes, it unfolds. If the trimming is finished, it comes to a stop. So Allah has tuned us with time. That's why I say ajal musamman, appointed time. And sooner or later, the time will finish. And when the time finishes, is our home kiyamun yazuru. We'll now see the day of judgment. And as I wish all of you and wish every Muslim and everybody to be amongst those that the Almighty Allah will say we should enter paradise amongst his beloved servants, who he was pleased with and will be admitted into paradise.
May the Almighty Allah reward us with Jannah al-Firdaws. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
La 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 la